हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? वेलकम टू माय एमएजू इनोवेटिव चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एम्स ऑफ टीचिंग इंग्लिश, द मेथोडोलॉजी। यू नो इंग्लिश इज ए फॉरेन लैंग्वेज बट वी यूज एज सेकेंड लैंग्वेज इन इंडिया। अकॉर्डिंग टू थॉमसन एंड वैट एंड अदर्स, the following six aspects have been taken into consideration as the general aims of teaching English. There are six aims: basic aims, general aims. One is semantic aspect, second is phonetic aspect, third is the graphic aspect, fourth is phonetic cum graphic aspect, fifth is the literary aspect, sixth is linguistic aspect. So these are the six general aims of teaching English. What is semantic aspect? You know, semantic aspect means meaning aspect. This deals with to know meaning of word and use in sentence. This is called semantic aspect. Then the phonetic aspect. What do you mean phonetic aspect? It deals with spelling and pronunciation. The children must learn how to spell the word and how to pronounce it. This is called phonetic aspect. Then the graphic aspect. What is graphic aspect? Graphic deals with the written form of the language. Written involves in three tasks. Mainly, graphic aspect means writing is a difficult task. It involves three tasks. Before, one is listening, second is understanding, then reading. Next, fourth point, the phonetic cum graphic aspect. Phonetic cum graphic aspect means combination of skills of pronunciation and writing. Here we have to do pronunciation and writing. This is called phonetic cum graphic aspect. This is the important aspect. Mainly it deals with reading skill. Then the last fifth point, the literary aspect. It deals with expression of language in beautiful manner. How to express the language in suitable or beautiful manner. This is called literary aspect. Understand? Then the last point is sixth, linguistic aspect means it deals with working knowledge of language. When we learn the language, we have to work with the language. We have to work knowledge of language. It's called linguistic aspect. Then broader aims and objective of teaching English. We know there are four basic skills. These are called broader skills. They are listening and understanding, then speaking and understanding the spoken words, third reading and understanding, then writing. These are the broader aims of English teaching. So these aims and objectives can be divided into two broad categories. One is receptive, other is communicative. What is receptive? Though we gain knowledge through listening and understanding and reading and understanding, so these two categories of aims are called receptive. And speaking and understanding and writing, these two categories of aims are called communicative skills. Friends, चलते हैं then principle of teaching English. We know there are some principles of teaching English. What are these? These are oral approach. Speech is the groundwork and all the rest in build on it. This is the groundwork, speech. We have to understand what is speech. This is the groundwork and all items, rest items are built on it. Then the vocabulary control. What is vocabulary control? Mastery of the language must mean something more than knowing all the words of the language. We have to mastery and the knowledge of language to learn a second language, you know. Then the vocabulary is therefore to be carefully chosen and should consist of about 2500 words of different kinds. We have to learn 2500 words at least, and we have to choose actual vocabulary to learn something, to progress our knowledge in English. So then use of structural approach. You know there are 275 basic structures in English. So we have to learn all structures carefully to improve our English knowledge. The construction of English sentence depends more upon order than inflection. This can be taught and learned best through drill in sentence pattern and phrase pattern rather than the rules. Then the fourth option, the selection and gradation of structures. We have to select and to grade for proper structure. We have to choose fast proper structure and we have to grade the structure after. Okay, then teaching one item at a time and next is to be taught when the former is mastered. When one item should be learnt, then other item must be taught. One item should be taught at a time and next item is to be taught when the first one has been firmly established. When the child learns one item, then he or she must learn another item. This means when child learn one item, then he or she would able to learn another item. Then minimum use of mother tongue. We have to use mother tongue rarely when we have taught English in the classroom. translation or mother tongue should be used when it is absolutely necessary rather than we can't use mother tongue in classroom. Then intensive drilling of structures. Intensive drilling of structures should be done. Intensive means बहुत अच्छे तरीके से हमको स्ट्रक्चर को समझना है और समझाना है बच्चों को, तो वी कैन क्रिएट एन इंग्लिश एटमोसफियर इन द क्लासरूम. फ्रेंड्स थैंक यू. आई होप दिस वीडियो मस्ट बी लाइक्ड बाय यू. शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब. थैंक यू.